Dudes, Andrew Gouche, do I need to say anything more?
Hey guys, how's it going? So I'm here with the amazing Andrew Gouche, who has...
How you doing? Today he is back in the house with us, and we're actually going to be talking about why he tunes his entire bass down a whole step. Now, you might have heard of guys doing this before, and it probably either goes back to Andrew Gouche. Or the late, great Joel Smith. It's also worth noting that the great Pino Palladino also has tuned down his bass for many albums a whole step, just like Andrew too. So without further ado, let's go to the studio.
Before we even get into like the stuff that you're playing, explain the tuning thing. Okay. Otherwise, people will be like freaking, they'll be playing the bass, right. And they'll be like, what? Yeah.
So I tuned down a whole step, and story behind that is, and I've told a story before, is when I started playing in the 70s, there was no such thing as a five-string bass. So growing up playing in church, a lot of the songs were in flat keys, E-flat, A-flat, B-flat. And it just used to piss me off to come right here to play E-flat.
Because it's high. If you're on that E-flat, the D as well.
It didn't sound like bass to me, you know. And so I started tuning down. And actually, a good friend of mine, Joel Smith, tuned down half step.
We talked about just before. Yeah.
He tuned down half step. So I wanted to be lower than him, so I tuned down whole step.
So there was no sort of like crazy theory about why half step and whole step, you just thought.
And it felt right when I did it, you know. And then when I got my first five string, I think it was 85. One of the most professional, baddest bass players you could ever meet. From California, Mr. Andrew Gouche. I have perfect pitch, so I'd gotten used to...
Have you got perfect pitch?
Yeah, which is a blessing and a curse, but that's why, you know. So I tuned down a whole step, and I've just done it for the last... Since 1981, I've been playing... tune that way.
And if people watching this will be thinking, like, should I tune down a half step or a whole step? Like, what would you tell somebody, like, if they asked you that?
I would tell anybody, you do what feels right to you. Yeah. You know, for me, it just feels right. And even when I tune up sometimes, it doesn't sound right to me. The bass sounds different.
Yeah, because the strings are going to have...
Yeah.
Might be have less tension in them, I suppose, aren't they? Yeah.
You can really tell the difference.
Because I've noticed that when you're doing your thing, like, you've got sometimes quite a lot of vibrato as well. Is that because the looser string, does it?
I think so. I use light gauge strings too, but for me, you know, I grew up around great singers, and I was always, it's just, playing the bass to me is almost like singing. There's, and then there's.
That, yeah.
Yeah, like, and you see me doing that a lot. Like, I'm doing.
Yeah, it's because it didn't vibe to the note, yeah. Exactly that, yeah. So it's always there, it's like one of those sort of like...
Especially on...
Articulations.
Songs like that, lower tempo songs, you know, obviously on fast songs, it's not going to be prevalent, but... to me, every note that I play means something, you know?
Yeah.
It's not so much about lines as it is about the notes, and I'm feeling the notes that I'm playing.
So now you know why a lot of gospel musicians tune down. Let's hear Andrew play a track so we can soak some of that groove up. We'll be right back. Dudes, hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know in the comments below who you want me to get in the hot seat next for you. And obviously, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel and switch your notifications on, as that way, next time I upload one of these bad boys, you're going to get notified about it. Obviously, I want to send some serious bass love out to Andrew Gouche as well for being part of what we're building over at scottsbasslessons.com. And with that in mind, if you haven't checked out scottsbasslessons.com yet, make sure you do so and grab a 14-day free trial as well, so you can, you know, take the ultimate online bass school for a test drive just to see if it's for you. Now, without further ado, take it easy and I'll see you in the shed.